Tell me in a sentence who you are.
See, I'm gay. I wasn't doing anything bad. I'm gay.
He came here with autism, and he's going to leave with autism.
Hey, get out of here, retard.
He's activated.
What am I doing in a place like this? Waiting for the most honest, true, and awesome woman to come around in my life.
Woo! It's me.
Michael, am I gay?
Why don't you suck a fart out of my ass?
But these are bad guys.
Why, you're one of the most beautiful women I've ever seen, and that's not saying much for you.
I absolutely dominate with my physical presence, with my smell, my pheromones, the way I talk, my eye contact, my hand motions, my body language. I dominate daily on a daily basis.
And I'm gonna wear my sunglasses at night. You know why? Because women show their tits, have short skirts, and then they feel violated when I look at them. Why? Because I have sunglasses on and I'm weird.
I'm gonna come.
It's really nothing.
Test.
You hear me?
Talking.
Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me now?
Good.
Hello. All right, that's a little too loud.
Oh. Yeah, I kind of yelled into the.
Yeah. Mic. You know, Mike, I'm gonna have to keep just a fist away from the microphone. Yeah, there you go. That's good. Yeah.
Fist away.
Yeah. Fist away, Mike. Come on. Fist no, not away. Like that. Like Rogan has to explain to people not to fist on his fucking podcast or video.
Or how to do it properly.
Yeah. How do you do it properly?
You gotta slide it in and then make the fist. That was like Tosh.0. He was like, common misconception. You slide it in, then you make the fist. You don't go around punching buttholes.
God, dude, I mean, that's the one thing, fisting ass, that's the thing that I check you out on any, like, people that are into that. I'm like, okay, whatever, bud. Like,
yeah, what do you just want to wear a diaper? Like, after,
yeah, exactly, yeah.
You know, for the rest of your life?
And it's like,
For what doesn't seem to be, like, that pleasurable. It just seems like you're, scratching, like, a centibite inch of deplorable.
Totally, dude.
At that point.
I can't even imagine fucking Cenobites doing fisting. That's going to involve, I don't know, like a lawnmower or a chainsaw fucking, you know, action going.
Yeah, there's probably a chainsaw.
You're going to be chopping
those guys, they tend to take it too far.
They always do, dude. You know, yeah. Usually I'm a fan of their antics, but not when it comes to fisting. I mean, no. My God, dude.
Mm-mm.
Yeah, and I never got it. Just like, you know, I like some, you know, sweet angel. I'm going to put my man fist in her butt.
Nah.
What the fuck, dude? Nah. What the hell's going on? What's the world coming to? It's like, you know, fucking, I hear that people are putting their fists in butts, and I'm just like,
when the hell did this happen?
Yeah.
Rule 34. If it can be done, it will be done.
Yeah, I guess. You know, I never looked up fisting in Rule 34, for good reason, but I'm sure there's some shit out there. Good Lord, dude.
Yeah.
A lot of Sonic the Hedgehog getting fisted by Dr. Robotnik. Dr. Eggman, I don't know, whatever the fuck. I was always confused by that. They call him Eggman and Robotnik?
Yeah, it's not two different guys?
Eggman? No, they're the same dude. Just like, they called him in Japan Eggman, and then in America they called him Robotnik for some reason.
Well, I thought he got a different degree under an assumed name. Like, he got a doctorate in, like, rocket science, and then...
Yeah, he's got a pseudonym.
And then in humanities.
Yeah. It was like, when he was Dr. Robotnik, that was like when Truman Capote wrote To Kill a Mockingbird for Harper Lee.
Yeah. Like, that's exactly what that is.
Yeah, that's what I think, yeah. Yeah. I mean, you know, basically.
I think that's what the Japanese were thinking. Yeah, yeah. They got bombed into...
To Kill a Mockingbird, Harper Lee... You'll happily kill a mockingbird? No, a happy read to kill a mockingbird. I don't understand. You mean... All right, we're talking circles here, bud.
Dude, that's why, you know, WOPpenheimer finally decided to drop the bomb on him. That movie that's coming out of the Italian, the strictly Italian stereotype?
Yeah, well, they came out with for the international release. In Italy, they're going to call him WOPpenheimer.
They thought it was more palatable.
So, you know, so the Italians can get it, and so fucking, it's like in Wappenheimer, he goes in and he makes the bomb, and he's like, oh, but if I bomb in Japan, can I still say that Olive Garden stinks and isn't as good as the food from my home country? And then Truman's like, or whatever, Eisenhower's like, yeah, fucking, I don't care, whatever, dude. Like, it really doesn't matter. You can bomb Japan. Then, oh, okay, then I bomb.
If I bomb Japan, can I still wrap my furniture in saran wrap and plastic?
I guess. But I mean, that has no bearing on obliterating two cities.
I bomb.
Oh, Christ, thank God.
Yeah, but it was when they ironically miscommunicated to kill Mockingbird, that's when he decided.
Yeah, because to him it was so serious, the story of a white lady lying about a black guy trying to rape her. You know, it was very serious that get out there.
Yeah.
He didn't want any miscommunication on that at all, dude.
No.
Yeah. And, you know, I think history has shown, dude, it happens a lot. Definitely does. Yeah, they're all lying. That's the thing. That's the thing with believe all women, unless it's a black guy. That's the thing.
Whoa.
That's the real Chinese finger trap of shit libs, you know?
Yeah. Or, you know, the hierarchy of, you know, social justice, I suppose.
Yeah. I still can't get over people, like, believed in, like, New York, that pregnant nurse was getting off her shift, and she decided then was the time to steal a bike from five black guys. Like, they thought that was what was going on. That was, like, a couple weeks ago. That was just so nuts.
Yeah. I can't even pay attention in New York, dude. It's so... Yeah. It's so dystopian.
Yeah, it's just fucking nuts, dude.
Well, the rest of the United States, too, I guess, at this point.
Yeah, I was thinking about that, too, because it's like, I don't know, a lot of these places are fucking crazy now, too. It's just like, you go out to, like, Montana, and they got, like, trannies in the fucking, you know, capital, like,
yeah,
doing all their shit. It's like, really? I'm in Montana, and I can't get away from this shit? What the hell, dude?
Yeah, I was watching Cuckle Tarleson. On Twitter, but he had a decent point. He's like, drive, like, you know, whatever arbitrary miles. He's like 50 miles in any direction. I think of, like, he was saying of, like, Washington, D.C. or something, whatever, but he's just like, go across, like, America and look at the state of it right now. I'm like, yeah.
Yeah, no.
And he's like, even in, like, small towns, they're like, you know, this huge, like, heroin problem.
So oh, definitely.
Yeah, it's this country a little afflicted, not to get doomer all of a sudden.
I know, we're having such a great time talking about how you know, white ladies lie about getting raped by black guys.
Yeah, not to change directions here.
We were riffing and roaring,
yeah,
dude.
Yeah.
I do like Wappenheimer. It's just so funny that he's Italian.
Yeah.
He's only, like, minorly upset about the bombing so much as it doesn't get in the way of his dumb Dago activities.
If I bomb in Japan, can I not have repressed sexual feelings with my sister and mother?
What the fuck? No, that doesn't have anything to do with bombing Japan, dude.
Yeah, you shouldn't be doing that anyway.
I'll still bomb.
I hear bomb.
Yeah, you know. Yeah, that was great, dude. When we cooked up Wappenheimer,
yeah,
that was our fucking Oppenheimer. I did feel like Shiva got a death. I'm like, look at the destruction I've wrought, dude.
To the Italian American community,
dude. I wish I could rue so much destruction. Those guys' time has come.
Has it? I feel like they've made amends, really.
Who?
They rehabilitated their image.
Oh, yeah,
the
I
Italians
guess.
These days. They,
yeah, I guess.
I feel like they integrated.
I think they almost did too much. Now they're like, they're like the Irish now, dude. We're both
that's what I mean.
We're just like the dogs of society, dude. Kicking us while we're down.
The dogs.
Yeah, no. Yeah, it's just, I don't know. That's the thing. It's easy to make fun of them because, you know, there's no real repercussions.
Consequence. Yeah, yeah. It feels good. It's in good territory right now. You know?
Yeah, I love it. It's great. anybody I can make fun of. And, you know, sort of like, you know, plunging down, especially with, you know, Italians. I mean, come on. That was the best when we were over at Luca's, and we were like, yeah, Italians, yeah, you'll step over your dying mother to go fuck your sister. And he was like, that sounds like something Irish would do. And I was just like, no, it doesn't.
Yeah, just nothing clever. No, it don't.
Actually, no.
No.
Oh, man, dude. Luca's been a trip, dude. He's fucking... I mean, I still can't get over, like... He's got to be, like, the ultimate troll.
He is.
Like, I... He's sort of like that, you know, drunken monkey fist.
Yeah, like Jar Jar Binks as a Sith Lord.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I think that's what he is, dude. I mean, seriously, this guy.
He's the final boss.
Like, and that's why it's so scary, because you never would have expected him to be the final
boss.
Yeah,
like Al Pacino in the Devil's Advocate.
Oh, I was going to say Jack and Jill. You never would have expected.
Yeah.
Mainly because you never watched the movie.
Yeah, I think that's the main barrier to that for me.
I like that he was in that movie. He's like, yeah, fuck it. I want to fuck Adam Sandler in drag. Yeah, I don't give a shit. Yeah, Dog Day Afternoon, Godfather, whatever.
Yeah.
And this.
Yeah. There he is.
He's like, oh, man.
I mean, De Niro. Like, dude, sure. Sure.
De Niro is such a fucking jackass, too, on top of everything. At least Pacino just kind of keeps to himself. De Niro's also like, we talked about it. He's just like, feels like he's a fake tough guy. And like, all right, dude.
Yeah.
Give me a fucking break. Him and, like, Ron Perlman, you know.
That guy just gets under my skin. Because it's like, they just buy into their own hype. Like, they've acted for so long, like, they don't realize the real world.
Yeah, and it's just like...
They'd get their ass beat if they were ever in an altercation.
Yeah, like, what the fuck, dude? Like, chill out.
Yeah, they're both, like, short. Just, like, guys. Like,
is Ron Perlman short?
I don't... He might be medium build, but, like...
Yeah, he might be, like... He's probably, like, Jameson's, like 6 foot.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Probably. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like, that's, like...
Where that's, like, a tall guy, but, like, not, like, tall.
Yeah.
Not, like, throwing your fucking words around like you're goddamn Conan the Barbarian.
Right.
You know. Anyways. But, yeah, I hate actors. But, you know, just fucking... Yeah, it's... So that's the thing with Luca, dude. Like, I mean, just the ultimate troll... He's, like, manipulating the scenes. You don't even see the strings, like, the puppet marionette strings that he's pulling off people, dude. Like, when we're at Dan's wedding, and he's, like, trying to fix me up with... Pretty much any woman that he tried to fix me up with was married or engaged. What the fuck, dude?
Yeah. What was that?
That's, like, the deepest troll of all. To, like...
That's a bad look. That's like, the anti-wingman.
That's, like, you're in the desert, and you give me a bottle of water, and it's, like, Purell. You know what I mean? Like, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah. Or vodka. Well, at least vodka.
That wouldn't be too bad. Yeah. I would like that.
Unless you're going to die not sober, they say. But yeah, what was it recently on the group chat? And somebody came in and was like saying like about like somebody from our graduating class.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Mentioning them. Like, did they die? And right away, Luke is just like, yeah.
This is like a dude that like... I knew from, like, grade school, too. So I knew him for years, and I was like, holy shit, like, he's dead? What the fuck?
Like, why would you lie about that?
Yeah, like, what the hell? And so then I asked him, like, really, is he dead? He's like, mm-hmm. Like, what? So I look up, like, my email. We didn't get any notice from our high school. So I'm like, yeah, I didn't get any email. He's definitely alive. Like, what the fuck? And then Jim, like, I don't even know what to make of Jim's contribution. How this guy's now in, like, South America, like, fucking...
doing, like, Spanish YouTube videos with, like, his lover.
Yeah, I'm like, what the fuck? Yeah. Who? What? Hey, what?
Yeah, I'm just like, whatever. I'm like, how... Like, who's keeping tabs on these people, too? I was thinking about that case. I'm like, you know...
There's, like, yeah, there's a lot of dudes that they'll bring up in the group chat that have died that I just, like, I don't even remember their face at all. Like, and it's, like, I, you know, kind of would have thought I'd know most people from our class, and nah, nothing. And I don't want to, like, say anything because I don't know, like, You know how, like, people, dudes are, like, a randomly, like, good buddies? They, like...
Yeah, right.
Like, a friend of yours has, like, a really close friendship for whatever reason of a guy you never would have thought about.
Right.
Yeah, it's... That happened to one chick, I won't say his whole name, but one chick back when we were in high school, like, knew a dude that we would always, like, say his name as, like, a... Basically as a punchline. And she's like, oh, yeah, that guy was, like, the coolest guy ever.
It's like, yeah,
you know, and fucking, I was like, what the fuck? This is like, you know, mind breaking, dude. I just can't get it. I can't believe that there are people that have lives and exist outside of my sphere of orbiting, you know?
Yeah. Why would I?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, what was that other thing? Just the last thing on the Luke. It was, about, like, Yakum. You texted, like, something about, like, Yakum.
Yeah. It was, because there was some, like, black thing we were talking about, and I was, like, just bullshitting, and I was like, yeah, I think he was, like, texting someone about Yakum, like, oh, yeah, like, you know, like, this is, like, just like how they all celebrate Yakum. And then Luke was just like, yeah, praise be to Yakum, with, like, black prayer hands.
Yeah.
And it's like, I just don't understand if he's trolling or serious. You know, that's the thing. It's,
yeah, what was going on with that?
And, like, then no one ever...
It's so out of, like, left field for Luca, one, to even have cognizance of that, because he's not, like, an internet, like, dark area retard like us.
No.
And then, like, he's just, like, normal-ish guy. And then, two, like, why would that be his response on top of everything else?
And then no one else, like, gets it, I guess?
Yeah, or touches it.
They just ignore it. So we're just looking at each other like, what the fuck? What's going on?
Yeah, like, I texted you outside. I'm like, dude, what? What?
Luke is going to be like that, like, Puerto Rican DC sniper that had the Jakob poster. Remember that? Yeah. That was the funniest thing ever, where it's like, yeah, sure, whatever.
The future of, like, black and white supremacist terrorists are just going to be, like, not black and white people, just respectively.
Indians and Puerto Ricans.
Yeah. And Italians as, like, black supremacists.
Yeah. Yeah, they suddenly fully circle back to, like, yeah, actually, it's cool to be black. Yeah, I love it.
Yeah.
Fucking, I still, how about the Indian guy that, like, crashed his van into the White House, like, fence?
Yeah.
And then had a Nazi flag?
Yeah, that's...
What, they just, like, that just plopped out and went right back? Because
as one does when they run into the gate of the White House, they pack a freshly folded Nazi flag, you know, with the creases on it that we've seen time and again.
Yeah, I was thinking...
you know, people with khakis and their fucking EDC carries protruding from their polo shirts.
I was thinking how funny glowing. It would be to be, like, a skit where it's, like... Because you see a lot of these, like, Nazi flags now, like, at these random fucking, like, photo op. Like, literally, they're photo op fucking moments.
Yeah.
Like, down in Florida... These dudes are, like, standing around with them, and they're, like, Nazis for, like, DeSantis was their sort of thing.
Yeah, I saw something like that,
and it's, like, they're down by Disney, and it's, like, yeah, okay, sure. Mm-hmm. Yeah, Nazis love DeSantis and his law that he signed in Israel about anti...
Yeah, like, if anybody...
Anti-BDS shit. Yeah,
right.
Sure.
Yeah.
Give me a fucking break. But so it'd be funny if there was a skit where it was, like the lone... like, Nazi flag factory in America that they pump out all the new Nazi flags for, like, Fed Ops and shit. Like,
yeah.
I don't know. And, like, Tim Robinson is, like, the factory floor manager of this fucking...
Yeah.
Just, you know, shit like it. Just...
That or, like, they take the next step and start, like, ironing them so they don't have, like, the new fold creases.
Well, yeah. We've innovated, you know, the Fed Op Nazi flag. Now, they're flat iron.
More
no
proof.
More, no more creases. No one will be able to say, hey, that's a brand new flag. You're making this up to make us look bad. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. That's a... Because it's like, I don't even know where you would fucking buy them. Like, they don't sell them on Amazon.
You can just grab them online probably somewhere.
I guess you're right. Yeah, what am I thinking? Of course you can.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, obviously, you can't if people are fucking get their hands on them. They're greasy mitts, dude.
Yeah, they're mitts.
Yeah, that was like we were at a gun show, and they were selling all these, like, shirts and shit, and I was walking around, and they had one for, like, Eric Rommel or whatever, the Desert Fox.
Yeah.
I'm like,
What the fuck?
Somebody who's a big fan of
him. Yeah, it's like, him. No, I like the military maneuvers. He's a brilliant general. It's like, okay, man. So you get a shirt of him, you're going to wear it.
Some people are, though. Some people are nerds like that.
Yeah.
Like, that's their thing.
Yeah, I mean, I get
yeah,
it.
Yeah, who's to say, yeah.
I mean, good lord, dude.
More so, yeah. Like, what are you going to wear a fucking Nazi on your shirt?
Yeah, like, good lord, man. Like, fucking... You can have, like, Genghis Khan, like, guy that, like, you know...
Yeah, that would be sick.
That would be sick, actually, as I say it. It's like, Come on. I do want a Genghis Khan shirt.
Yeah.
And one where he's got red hair and...
Yeah, I was just gonna say. As we know, through our...
My name is Robert Sepp.
There we go. There it is. Nice.
How about him now being, like, actually every black civilization... Was just white guys.
Yeah, that was unbelievable. He's going too far. This man, he's going crazy. It was like somewhere like central like Africa. It was like Chad.
Yeah, it was like Mansa Musa or whatever.
Yeah, like it was deep sub-Saharan. Like probably hadn't been like seen a white person. Like
it's literally like yeah, like it's
since
past,
like the 20th century.
It's past the desert, so it's that part where it's definitely like the Nubians and like the like central African sort of civilization. Like, I get the idea of, like, then there's the sort of northern Africa is just the southern Mediterranean.
Yeah, right.
That jives with me.
Western, yeah.
I get that. But then, like, you go past that, it's like, I don't know, buddy. You're really...
Yeah, no.
You're losing me.
He's going crazy with it. Yeah.
I just don't know. And then he's like, Muhammad was white. I'm like, I don't know, man. Like, what do you...
Yeah.
What's to be gained?
I don't know. Like, that one... has some plausibility to me because there's tribes of like the Berbers in North Africa and they're like there's to this day still have like blue eyes.
That's true.
And it has been like I've heard it before and there is evidence like at least like not evidence but like they do dye their hair like orange.
Yeah.
Like in homage to them and stuff like to this day like you see it in Afghanistan, you see it in North Philly too.
Yeah, I have seen that.
Yeah,
it's
weird.
That's
for that, yeah.
They look like that guy on Fox News, Tyrus, the fat ex-wrestler. He's like we should just have tax cuts, man. Like, he's like one of those kind of guys who's like, you know, I'm not your typical conservative. Like that type of deal.
Oh.
Yeah.
Like trying to be a populist or like...
I don't know. Just like,
yeah, I
just
can't.
Kind of like they just want to have like a menagerie of people, so it's not just all like you know.
Oh yeah, like who they're trying to.
Sean Hannity types.
Yeah.
They want like other types of guys coming in,
right?
To like
right.
sort of bolster, but doesn't really seem to matter.
No. Nah.
Yeah, that was like I think Vivek, that dude. He was like in Chicago, and he's because it was that shit we were watching, where like they're all going nuts about the immigrants coming in.
Yeah.
And Vivek was like. See, this is why you should vote for Republicans, because we're not going to... I'm staunchly anti-immigration, especially legal immigration, and I'm going to fight that these things aren't, like, you know, going to happen in your communities. And they were all just like, man, like, he's like in a barber shop. And they're just like, man, what the fuck? I don't know. I'm not voting for no Republican. It's like, okay, cool. Great. You know, whatever.
People's minds are already made up.
Yeah. Vivek's a trip, dude. He's really just like a nerd. That like makes good points, but I don't know. It's not gonna get you anywhere, dude.
Yeah, it's a popularity contest, unfortunately.
Unfortunately, but yeah, you know, dude, I'm struggling with fucking our guy, the Just. He you know challenged me not to bring up.
Trainings. Oh, for the entirety of Pride.
Yeah. It's an extreme challenge, especially when you got the Biden White House just having like Neo Babylon current on the front lawn of the White House.
Yeah, yeah.
Good lord, dude. Yeah, I that's like almost a thing where I'm looking at it and it's like this is like the craziest thing that like people watch this and just think it means nothing and like whatever. But then also I'm stepping back and being like, wait, is it really? Like, am I blowing it up? I don't know. It's like I'm at a loss sometimes with some of the crap that they fling out, you know?
It's like, well, it's such an oppressed class of people that
It is, dude. Yeah.
You know.
Definitely.
It's just, you know, every corporation and seemingly like every portion of our government in the United States is just on its side waving the flag and countries abroad and
yeah.
But you know, that's about all I have to say about that.
Yeah, I guess.
You know,
I'm trying to keep to this challenge, dude. So
yeah, yeah,
I just felt like, you know, I'd be remiss if I didn't bring it up.
Remiss.
I'd be remiss. I'm remiss. Do you even know what that means, George? Well, it's when you miss something and then you think about it later and you re-miss it. That is the stupidest thing. Oh, man, dude. That's how things have been, Mike.
You know, good. Good. You know, smooth sailing.
It's great to hear, man.
Been enjoying the weather.
It's been beautiful, really. Honestly, yeah. Like, kind of surprising. Like, really not crazy hot for June. You know, pretty fucking nice, dude.
Yeah.
I'm loving it. Can't complain.
Cormac McCarthy, we lost a legend.
I know.
I think he's 89.
It's a shame. He, yeah, I mean, he's an old guy to begin with. Left a long, pretty solid body of work, I would say.
Probably,
you know, pretty easily the best writer of the last century.
You could say that.
Yeah, and, well actually,
wait. Harry Potter?
Well, he's the best writer. Well, he kind of bled into the end of the one, into this one. So far, he's best of this century. How about that? We'll go by that.
All right.
Because I was thinking like Hemingway, Raymond Chandler,
yeah.
Faulkner. I mean, that's pretty steep competition.
Yeah.
Faulkner's pretty good. So.
We have them, them Russian guys, right?
Yeah, but I was thinking more like American.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, you got the Russian guys. Don't forget about the Russian guys. Tolstoy, who's the other guy? Fucking Dostoevsky or whatever.
Yeah, that's the one.
Dusty Epstein.
I really don't know like big swaths of just like classic literature. I don't even know. I'm out to lunch for a lot of shit like that.
Yeah, you should do that thing. I did that in like in high school. I was really big on. They had the. Time magazine top 100.
You were telling me,
and it's mainly I think from the like 1900s to you know the 2000s, and it's all like American stuff for the most part. So it's not like super nuts. It's like stuff you could pretty much get into, and a lot of the stuff you'd be surprised you already read. So like it's not like you're starting from scratch, going through the list, and a lot of cool stuff on there. You know, like Blood Meridian. That's on there. You know.
BM.
Bowel movement. That was his significantly less successful sequel to Blood Meridian. Yeah, they scrapped that one.
It went straight to VHS.
Yeah. Oh, man. But, yeah, dude. I don't know. Just loving life, dude. Just living it, gripping it, and ripping it. You know, that type of thing.
Living la vida loca.
It is loca, dude. Sometimes, you know, man, it's like...
Locomotion.
Yeah, I guess. What is a locomotion? Like a locomotive.
Locomotive.
Locomotion. See? There you go. You solve it. It all goes together. Oh, man, dude. Dude, fucking... The Celtic Cross is getting really fucking popular out of nowhere, dude. Like, what the hell?
Yeah.
All the Zoomers and Zoomettes are over there, dude. Like, what the fuck?
Blowing up, man. Well, they did like a bar rescue to themselves.
They did. They rescued themselves from the abyss.
Yeah. I mean, the abyss is what we liked about it.
I love really. The abyss.
give me the hole in the wall. When they repaired the hole in the wall, I knew things were in trouble.
But yet I said nothing.
Yes, yeah.
I love showing people that photo view with Nick and Dan. Like, Dan like flew across the country to meet back up with us, and you're like, "Yeah, here's that hole in the wall I was telling you about." People like love it, dude. It's so great. Yeah, I mean, goddamn, dude. Yeah, I That's my favorite thing with that place. It's just like swings so like radically between like, you know, like mobbed on a Saturday out of nowhere, and then like fucking
of like 14-year-olds to
right like
to
yeah, dude, you don't want to find yourself in a Rob Lowe situation where you're fucking, you know, at a bar.
It's
fucking crazy, dude.
No, which is why I asked for two verified forms of identification.
Yeah, Social Security.
Before any physical contact.
Yeah, I'm still waiting on that Israeli facial recognition technology goggles to come in. One day it'll come
in. Yeah.
And I'll have nothing to worry about. Absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
Yeah, so then, you know, it swings from that to, like, fucking, I went there the other night to, like, watch the NBA Finals. Like, for, I wanted to see the Nuggets win. I go there, they're not playing the Nuggets. It's just Phillies on, like, all five TVs. And it's just one other guy there. I'm like, God damn it, dude. Like, what the fuck? It's like, you know, just, can't just have a normal crowd, like, most nights. Like,
no.
What the fuck, dude? I don't know. Even to watch the Phillies, I'd think there'd be a couple people. Nope. Why would there be?
Yeah. How about, speaking of lack of patronage, big thing is that thing happened on 95.
That's right. We could talk about that. That totally left my mind because I don't really ever have to use 95 for the most part.
Yeah.
And it's just, I don't know. It's kind of fucked up the boulevard, though. Like, that's gotten busier as I've gotten out of work. Like, that's really getting backed up where it normally wouldn't, at least from my experience. But yeah, dude, I went to fucking get nuggies last Sunday, like, the day it blew up. I went to, like, go to McDonald's, and, like, I get to that intersection, and it's, like, fucking packed to shit. I'm like, what the fuck's going on, dude? And little did I know, there was, like, fucking, yeah, the Blazing Inferno took off, dude. How about that fucking video? That lady, she's just, like, driving down 95, just engulfed in
flames.
Nuts, dude. And then the guy.
She drove over it before a collapse.
Right before.
Yeah.
Like, literally right before.
She was one of the last people.
It's crazy, man. And then, like, the guy that, like, was in the tanker, the video of him just, like, like, right into the underpass.
I didn't see that.
Yeah, he's.
That's cool.
Because it's like one of those, I guess it's like one of those things where you're like turning off and you're going like 60 and then immediately is like, yeah, now you got to go to like 25 right now, you got to slow down.
Yeah.
It's an extreme curve, like literally the worst designed fucking roads.
Yeah, how about that for the exit off of, to get off Conshohocken from like 76?
Oh, dude, that's like.
Is like a fucking 90 degree turn and it's not like one of those on ramps where you're like inclined to like slow down. It's just like you pull off the side of the road, like on the right side, and then you're there, and then it's like that, and you can see on the guardrail, like I always look, you just see like the graveyard of like benchmarks of when people ate shit into the side of it.
Dude, it looks fucking like heinous, some of the shit that's like people definitely just rammed right into that shit.
Yeah, you know
it. Dude, yeah, people, I mean, that's like especially at night, dude. It's tough to get off those fucking exit ramps sometimes. Like, one time I was driving, and, like, it was so late at night, I didn't even know if I, like, literally saw it. But, like, a guy's going off the exit, and then, like, I'm driving. Then in the back mirror, it looked like he literally, like, swerved off the curve, like, over it, into, like, down in the grass area. And I was like, what the fuck?
Oh, shit.
I don't know, like, yeah. And it was, like, late at night. Like,
yeah.
It was kind of like, who the hell knows? And I'm, like, getting out of the car at that point would have been kind of tough for me, too. But I was like, good Lord, dude. People fucking, it's tough, man.
Yeah. And, like, some people just drive, like, psychos all the time. I was telling you, like, the other day, I'm, like, going to work, and it's, like, 9 or 10 in the morning. And, like, this guy's, like, going, like, fucking 100 miles an hour, like weaving in and out of driving. People are just trying to like drive to work, and you have like this jerk off like doing that. It's like, dude, what are you doing? Like, just like ripping PCP, or is that just like off of like two cups of energy drink or something? Like, you're just driving like that.
Yeah, dude, I mean,
it's like every day probably for that person.
Dude, I fucking hate those, like the worst kind of people that do that bob and weave thing.
Yeah,
like, and they're just like ripping like really not a lot of clearance between one car and the next.
Yeah.
That, I saw one dude do that on the boulevard. It's literally like he's waiting for the space to open up, and then like he's right, like angling right next to both of the cars.
Yeah.
Just so he can pop through. And I'm like, dude, like, if they tap their brakes, you're fine.
Right. Just to shave off, like, probably 2 minutes on a commute or something.
Yeah, and it's not like fucking, like, oh, I gotta get in this lane. It's like, I'm, yeah, exactly. Like, I gotta get to where I'm going 5 minutes faster.
Yeah, so I can, if you know, that, yeah.
Suck dicks.
Yeah, so I can, faster. Yeah, stuff a bunch of stuff in my...
I gotta go
my
get.
Rear.
I gotta go get fisted. All right, guys.
Yeah, I got
really, really tight schedule.
I got an appointment. Yeah,
it's the
I
only
get,
thing in my
get
life
fisted
that's tight.
At 6 yeah, for now. I gotta get fisted at 6, and then at 7 I got a late night orthodontist appointment. It's crazy.
Ugh, he's got braces.
Good yeah, word. he's got adult braces.
Ugh, God, that happened to my dad. He had adult braces for I think when he got married.
Yeah,
it was like. Damn, dude. I don't know. I always had pretty good teeth, dude. I'm getting my fucking wisdom teeth pulled out soon.
You're going to lose all your wisdom.
I know. That's what I'm literally kind of worried about what it's going to be like once they're gone. Because that is a thing that they say. Like, you're supposed to, you know, if you can deal with them growing in, they're, like, kind of good for your jaw and, like, for your mouth.
But yeah.
These are really fucking me up. They kind of got to go. But, I don't know. I'm looking forward to the procedure, but it will be nice.
No, dude, done. It's somebody at my work just had it done. They literally just put you out and you wake up.
Yeah.
It's not a big deal at all.
They'll be sick.
Yeah, it's like, I was like thinking, I was like, imagine before anesthetic what they had to do, but like, you're literally, like, and I've had surgery in like 2 years ago or something, and it's the same thing. They literally just put you under and you're fine.
Yeah, it's the only thing that was like, so the doctor was like telling me like after the thing, like, you have to get these blood clots that form so they like stop the bleeding, and then those can pop out sometimes, blah blah blah. So like explaining it to me, like, if those pop out and your bones are gonna be exposed, you can get an infection, your mouth could fall off. I'm like, what was that? And then she's like really going through it like fast, and I'm like kind of like, whoa, what the hell? And she's like basically saying all this stuff, like, I gotta be super on top of it for like a whole week or two. Like, I can't stop thinking about it, or like my mouth could get fucked up. I was like, do you want me to like even get this procedure? Because you're not selling me on it.
I think they're just trying to cover their ass.
Maybe, yeah.
More dude. Than anything else.
Kind of sucks, dude. They're not giving me any like painkillers. They're like, yeah, just take Tylenol, stupid.
Yeah.
Like, fuck, dude.
I think it'll be fine though once they're out. Like, when I got mine taken out, I didn't need any painkillers whatsoever.
Yeah,
like, it didn't even hurt. Like, I'm saying, like, it wasn't even like painful at all, so
yeah,
probably be fine.
And that's what I'm hoping is, because it's been like a few years now, because they grew in real bad back in like 2019, and I kind of just put it off because like I didn't really have any money to get the surgery. Yeah. And then, you know, the pandemic hit, and like, you know, for a while it seemed like you couldn't even get fucking dentist appointments because of that shit. I don't know. But like, dude, a couple months ago, they just fucking started killing me out of nowhere, dude.
Yeah,
I know this is riveting podcast.
Yeah, but this was still awake.
Yeah, my teeth—they hurt really bad, and now I'm worried about when they get pulled out. Well, it's actually not too bad.
Yeah,
I've had my, yeah, great. fuck, goddamn.
Yeah, now I was seeing like that dream map, and apparently like the most common dream around the world, globally almost, in like a lot of countries, is people's teeth falling out.
Yeah, what's up with that? You know, like, what does that sort of symbolize, do you think? Your teeth falling out.
I don't know.
Is that like
it almost is like a primordial one.
So I would think your teeth, you can't, like, I don't know.
Are you thinking, like, associations?
Yeah, I'm trying to associate it. So, like, you're eating, you know, taking in energy.
Yeah.
It's like a tool that you can feed your spirit with.
Right.
Or something like
that. Right, right, yeah.
Your aggressive, your ability to fend for yourself, to feed yourself. There's, like, a sort of like a, you know, disability sort of thing. I don't know.
Yeah.
That's kind of, yeah.
More than I had on it. I'm just
like, probably.
Shit doesn't. Yeah, like, I never got afraid of that because I was like, I'll just get like a fucking like silver tooth. I feel like I could just do that. Wouldn't be bad.
Yeah, I think that would match your vibe totally, yeah. Mike.
Thanks. Yeah. You know, the little silver tooth going on.
Yeah, you got the silver tooth. You got like a gold Greek chain.
Yeah.
And then, like, you know, Hawaiian shirt. And, like, 70s pants. Yeah, you're all set, dude.
Yeah. Why not?
Yeah, man. Dude, I had like, I had a couple of weird dreams. What was the one? Oh, there's the one I was telling you where, like, it was you and me were hanging out, and then Kenny Chesney and Bryce Harper, like, were sent to as assassins to kill us. And, like, I look over as they're
Who's Kenny Chesney?
He's the country singer. Yeah. And it's the both of them. Like, and they're both, like, working in sync. Yeah. And, like, we both look over as they're about to attack us, yeah. And we catch them, and we're like, what the fuck? Are you guys trying to, like, assassinate us? And they're like, no, we're not trying to assassinate you. But if we did, we would do this. And they do, like, another move.
Yeah.
And we catch that, and they're like, you caught that one. I would never assassinate you like that. I would maybe try like this. Like,
so bizarre.
You catch that? I'm like, Bryce, why are you doing this?
It's like an Austin Powers or something. Like, Mark's, I can't even... Yeah, dude. Speaking of which, who's more scary as a guy trying to kill you, Chesney or Harper?
Harper's jacked, dude.
I would agree. Harper is more of a physical presence.
He's like fucking like 6'2".
Are you
like,
serious? Yeah.
He's like yoked.
Yeah, he's like a big
He's
dude.
Not just like, because that's the thing of baseball, yeah, like schlubs.
Right.
He's just like standing there and his arms popping out of his fucking uniform. Yeah, dude. It's fucking crazy, dude.
That guy, yeah, he's a physical presence.
Yeah. And because he's like all he's done since he was like 10. Is just, right. Like play baseball.
And work out.
And like, yeah, for like fucking, what has that been, like fucking 20 years now? Like,
yeah.
Christ, dude.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy. So, yeah, that was in the dream. That was frightening when he was trying to stab my eye with,
yeah,
like,
well, you know, you don't...
Weird knife.
Yeah,
them like the
push
handle,
knives. Yeah,
the handle that you go around.
I know what you're talking about.
Pops out like, yeah, a middle finger. And he tried to stab me in the face with
it's
it.
It's like an assassin's blade.
And I stopped him. You know, real Chuck Norris style.
Yeah, good on you.
Yeah, well, you know, he should have known better than the,
yeah,
trifle against us, dude. I mean, my God, dude.
And that would, the coyness of it all after he was denied, like, that would twist me up the most, because, like, average ruffian comes in the house, pulls a knife on us, fool us once.
Shame on us.
Yeah,
dude.
Try to fool us twice, can't get fooled again. We're going to give you a blast, dude.
Yeah, dude.
We're not getting treaded on. But if it was Harper playing a coy fish upon us, I don't know if I could bring myself to assassinate the assassin.
I know.
If he's playing that card.
It was troubling, dude. I gotta be honest. It, yeah, was really... I had to deal with that when I woke up the next morning. I was like, that is weird. Weird dream. I don't know what to make it... It's not like I listened to Kenny Chesney either. I don't know I don't know what he had to do with anything. At least I watched the Phillies. Like,
yeah,
what the fuck?
Right. That's working overtime.
Dude, how about the one fucking dream I had? I don't think I talked about this in the cast, where we were in the living room, and we had, like, a fucking window that was open, and then, like, these guys in bear outfits came and, like, tried to break open a window into our living room.
Yeah.
And, like, they tried to, like, break into our house. I was like, what the fuck? And, I grabbed a shotgun, chased them off. And it's me and Utina. We're hanging out. And, like, so me and her are, like, scouring into the streets trying to find these guys. We find the one. And I'm, like, so enraged that they even dared to, like, break into my house.
Yeah.
This is, honestly, it's not even Castle Doctrine at that point. They're way away from the house at this point.
Yeah.
I'm just so mad in the dream. I, like, take the butt end of the rifle. I'm, like, bashing this guy's head in, like, because I'm so mad. Like,
yeah.
What the fuck? Like, bro, I'm spooked in the dream. And then as I'm walking away, I hear, like, this voice just whisper, like, this is what they're going to do to Christ when he returns. And I was like, what the fuck? You tell me this is what... I didn't mean to do this to Jesus. What the fuck, dude? And I look back and it's him. And I'm like, what the fuck?
Truly, I say unto you, the least you do for my brothers, you do unto me.
Yeah, I was like, what the fuck? And I turned to Utz and I was like, did you know who was Jesus? She's like, I didn't fucking know.
I just picture it as, like, the Wafu and... an archer for Hitler's clone.
Oh, yeah, like it's a hologram.
Yeah, yeah. And she's like speaking in Japanese. It's not even like the American Utena.
No, yeah.
Yeah.
that was crazy, man.
Yeah. And then I had this one that was really weird. It was like I was back in grade school, and there's this lady I work with that I have a crush on who's like an older woman.
Nice.
And she was like a teacher, and I was like in fifth grade or something like that, and like everybody had a crush on her. And so we were sitting in a like school assembly thing. We're watching like a really bizarre. It was like if it was like a like government PSA about how we're all going to grow up to be like starfighter pilots, like in Star Wars.
Yeah.
Like we all have to watch like and get like in a propaganda video about fighting the Empire or something like that.
Yeah.
Or fighting for the Empire. You know, yeah.
The Iraq War, too.
Yeah. So then, like, I was watching it, and then I just started to try to do, like, sit-ups or whatever. Or, like, sit-ups.
We're not wasting any time.
Yeah, and then, like, she, like, looked over me, and she's like, hey, are you not paying attention? And I was like, no, I'm paying attention. And she's like, okay, fine. And then everyone's like, ooh. And then I, like, got up, and I went to a water fountain. And, like, in the dream, as a fifth grader, I was, like, singing a song. It's like, I want to kill myself.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
And I woke up, and I was like, what the fuck, man? Good Lord.
This is what I got to deal with?
Like, yeah.
Can't just go to sleep at night?
Like, Jesus Christ. It's a lot to unpack, you know?
Yeah, that is a lot to unpack.
But,
how was it received when you told your work crushed?
No, I mean, I literally can't.
No, that would be abysmal.
It's a bit of a language barrier.
Yeah.
That's the worst part.
I had a dream, like, last night, and it was, like, I don't even think it was, somebody about my work, a lady at my work, and, yeah, but it wasn't, I don't think it was, like, overtly, enmeshed, so to speak. Physically, it was just
enmeshed.
Yeah, in rainbows and enmeshed. I think she like graduated college or something. She was like asking for like directions to like a liquor store or like what like vodka she should buy. And I'm like, this one. And like, that's it. And like, yeah, I was like, I saw her at work today. I'm not going to tell her that I had a dream about it. I don't want to make people uncomfortable.
That was the thing I fought where I was like, I literally can't say anything because it's like such a weird thing to say. You know?
Yeah.
Like, yeah. I don't know like what level you have to be with somebody to say that you had a dream about them. Like,
well, I would imagine if you're banging them or you want to bang them.
Yeah. So that's the thing. Like, I think you'd have had to have already smooched if like, you know, you want to. You can't just, because if you say like I had a dream about you and like, you haven't smooched,
well,
that goes from they're politely like getting along with somebody at work who's a mega creep.
Oh, well, yeah, that's at work, yeah.
That's the type of thing. Yeah. To, like, you know, that's that, like, right. They switch to that mode real quick if you're not reading it right.
Right.
And, you know, so. But, yeah, I had another weird dream where it was, like, fucking, we were in some, like, palatial estate.
What's a palatial?
Palatial, like a big mansion, like a palace. Yeah, so it was, like, a real big, sort of like something like the DuPonts or, like, the Rockefellers would be.
Oh, yeah.
And we were on some, like, weird, like, class trip, like as a college group or something like that.
Yeah,
and it was just, like, fucking really weird. Like, I was watching, like, hentai in, like, a glass, sort of, like, glass-walled, like, room. Like, it was sort of, like, just, like, trying to jerk off and, like, looking around making sure no one was seeing me. I was like, what's going on, man?
A time like this.
Yeah, it's just really bizarre, you know. This is just the stuff that goes through my head, I guess. Right, yeah.
And what's your theory on the dreams?
I really don't know.
In general,
sometimes I think they're very literal. Yeah. Like the one, you know, the where I'm in grade school, I think it's pretty literal. But then, like, it's like the other ones. It's like, Christ, I mean, I just don't know.
Yeah. So, in that one Jung book, Man in the Symbols, I read into that, and they often take it, that's like a big part of Jungian psychology and practice, they take apart dreams, and they were saying it's like literally your greater self or subconscious trying to like communicate to you, and because it's such a different kind of entity that like exists not in the same like linear time frame, it communicates through symbols And it's, you know, it's up to you to, like, figure out what those symbols are. You think it would just talk to you and be direct, you know?
Nope.
It's like, come down to my level. You want to be, you know, that rude. But I think something... Oh, yeah, that... Actually, I remember now my other dream from last night, which is great because it kind of segues. Another thing they said is dream spaces, if you start, like, recording them, they often repeat. And they carry over similar or the same meaning.
Oh, so if you, like, wake up, remember it, mm-hmm. think about it, then it'll sort of be implanted?
Well, just in any means of recording it, whether you're journaling it or telling somebody else, but I'm saying very literally, like, a space within your dream, like an area, like, say that mansion,
yeah.
would reoccur often. Often, more often than we think about, because we forget a lot of the ones.
Yeah.
So that was weird, because, like, I heard that, I'm starting to pick up on that a little bit. And, I dreamed last night, and it was this building that was, I already had a dream about prior, but I forgot that one, but I remember the building specifically. And it was like I was going around in it, and I was like running around. I was like running so fast, I was like floating up the stairs like a ghost, and I was like trying to find my room. And it was like I was with my a lot of like my college roommates.
Okay. Yeah.
So I open up the one door, and it's like these four girls, and they're like my roommate, and I'm like, oh, like, sorry, like I just like abruptly ran in there, and I like felt like I wasn't supposed to. So I like went to the next one, and then I went to like where my one roommate was supposed to be, and it was like all dark, and it was supposed to be like really scary. And my other roommate's like passed out there, and he's like asleep, and I'm like, oh, well, it's this guy. But then I kind of woke up, but I was like mapping out the whole house. And then I remembered in the morning it was the other place, or the same place rather, which is interesting. And both of which, the house doesn't exist in real life.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
which is cool.
Yeah, it's interesting. That's yeah, dude. I mean, I hope I have more dreams in that palatial estate, dude. That's pretty nice.
Not
dude.
A bad pad. Yeah,
it was nice. Like, there was like a group of like Asian MILFs that came through, and like they were like asking us if we were gonna swim, and you went up to the one, and you're like, I'll swim if you're gonna swim. And she was like, what? It's nice, dude. It's good dream.
Yeah, it's a good field trip right there.
Yeah, it was pretty sick. The only thing that was like scary is like literally I had this creeping feeling that like I was gonna get murdered by like some like retard like third cousin of a DuPont who's like they don't let out.
Oh yeah, like one of the Kendys had one of them too. Yeah, yeah,
like
they're
just like
yeah,
lurching
yeah.
around. You know,
yeah,
you know?
Hills Have Eyes or something.
That was kind of what was that? The Foxcatcher. That was that movie with Steve Carell and like Armie Hammer, and it was like a wrestling thing, college wrestling, and like he was like a coach, Steve Carell. I think he was like a DuPont.
Yeah,
I think he killed whoever he was coaching, and he was kind of like a weird sort of spurg because they're like kind of like, you know, inbred, I guess, to
yeah,
an extent.
Right.
I don't know. So that was kind of like in the back of my mind. I was thinking about that the whole time. Well, I'm jerking off the hentai.
Yeah, what's the Kennedys' excuse? They, like, the DuPonts at least had, like, you know, four generations of trying to retain wealth, you know, or so what.
Well,
but, like, the Kennedys were just, like, Irish. Yeah, they came from, like, bootleggers. They weren't trying to keep their money in the family.
Yeah, they're only, like, maybe one or two generations in America.
Yeah, the fuck out of here.
Yeah, dude. yeah, I mean, good Lord, dude. Yeah, we gotta watch that. The what is it, the Beals of Grey Gardens? That's like the ones where I think it's Jackie Kennedy's family. So they're not necessarily the Kennedys. They're like, it's not Onassis. That was her second husband, whatever maiden name was. But like, they're like real retards where they're like just living on like Long Island or something like that.
Yeah,
and they're like in some like rundown house, and it's like just nuts. They're living like with raccoons and shit.
Yeah, what the fuck.
And they're like, you yeah. know, a call away from the White House the whole time.
Yeah,
it's fucking nuts.
That's the thing. It's well, yeah, it's crazy it is that close, but that kind of spirit of, I guess it's everywhere, you know. But like the thing about like the Americana flavor of it, and like the American flavor particularly, saw it, and we might have talked about it prior a long time ago, but in the Crumb documentary, where like that weird, you know, salt of the earth, like, because that's in Philadelphia, and you just see, like, just especially coming out of, like, the generation they're coming out of, like, it's just weirdos, but, like, never went anywhere. Today, like, you can still see, like, some people crawling around in, like, Kensington, I feel like.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Especially, like, his one brother, who was, like, the guy who was, like, he would, like, sexually assault women in, like, drugstores. Like, that guy, I mean.
What the fuck?
You could see, you could easily see him just slinking around fucking K&A.
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Not even on drugs, just, like, one of those weirdos.
Exactly, yeah, that's more so, yeah, to the point, without the chemical influence. It's just like this pure weirdness that it's just like generational weirdness.
Yeah, like I don't know, man.
It's there. I mean, you hear about it famously, like, down south, of course, like Deliverance or some shit. Yeah, like, we get it, you know, backwoods.
Yeah.
Whatever, but it's there in the major cities. Like, you know, it's like in, like, you know, every major, like, city.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah. Yeah, it's, you see it sometimes. Even, like, especially around here, you'll see it pop up here and there. Just go to fucking Wawa at, like, the middle of the night. Some of the fucking windows pop up.
Coming out.
It's like, what the hell, dude?
And I guess, like, racistly on my end, it's easier for me to, I guess, identify or, like, have, like, less, have more transparency with, like, the white people of the city who are like that. You know, for whatever that means, I don't fucking care. But
yeah, no, I get what you're saying.
Yeah, it's because sometimes there's, like, I think it's particularly because, like, black culture is just, like, it in itself, like, a subculture, and it's has a little bit of obfuscation. Is that a word? Is that a real word?
Yeah. Well, it's like something you don't really know about, like, inherently.
So yeah.
So there's, like, I mean, it's a real thing that I don't think gets talked about a lot, like. The idea that you could just, like, look at someone and at a glance have a general idea of what the, so, like, that's kind of like that whole birds of a feather thing.
Yeah.
And it's just easier for people to look at people who are like them. They think there's some level where they're on the same page just to start out with.
Yeah.
Versus, you know, when you look at someone who isn't, it's just, you got to sort of be on your toes to an extent.
Right. Well, I'm saying for the, to be able to see, and people who are from the same genetic pool or whatever demographic, it's easier to see what's really fucked up about them on the surface. Yeah, yeah. So what's wrong rather than what's relatable.
Well, that probably goes into it where, like, you do have a starting point.
Right.
And then you kind of have a way to, like, you know, grade, like, on a curve, like, where, how fucked up they are.
That's definitely a real thing for me. And it's a real thing for everybody, whether they want to ignore it or not. It's just a fact of life. It doesn't make anybody bad or good.
Yeah, that's, I would say.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. I mean,
it's, and it all comes down to both individuals and any particular dynamic interaction. So it's not really a generalization.
Yeah. No, I think you spelled it out pretty good, dude. Yeah. I mean, I think that's a real thing.
But yeah, you see that, and you see these guys. These guys.
Dude, yeah. I mean.
And what's going on with the, you know, back in their house, and.
That's, dude. Yeah, like, literally, like, some people, it's like, what do they do all day?
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, what are they fucking thinking? What are they trying to work towards? I don't get it.
Yeah, it's just so divergent of and, you know, thank God, and I guess it's so necessary, you know, on a metaphysical level, for you need, like, these deviations to just manifest, because, like, how like we were kind of saying before the big show.
You kind of sound like a Job from fucking Restaurant, like, the show.
Yeah, the magician show that's taking place before your eyes, the audible magician show where you're listening to magic here.
The illusions.
This girl, that girl. Yeah, the illusionary
American
experience.
Indiana's fair podcast.
American Indiana's, thank you very much. Yeah, the we're just plugged into the stream of information, you know, whatever flavor of you know, Soylent you're getting, you know, via like media and social media feed, so you can have your pre-approved opinion.
Yeah.
Not on this podcast, though. You get the unadulterated truth, boys and girls.
Yeah, you're getting it raw.
Getting that doggy raw.
Diggity, diggity dog, dude.
It's like fucking a wet willy.
It is like a... We're the wet willy of podcasting. That's...
I've always said that.
Yeah, you've always...
You've always said that.
It's a nice running gag. Yeah. You've always said that. Dude, how about I was talking to my mom about... Because I was listening to, like, No Agenda. I was over at my folks, yeah, helping them put together stuff. And so I was listening, like, to No Agenda while we're doing it. And they were talking about, like, Sandy Hook, about how, like... Kamala Harris had this thing where she was speaking publicly about, like, oh, I challenge anybody to look at the, like, autopsy photographs of Sandy Hook and, you know, say it didn't happen. And they were like, as far as we know, there were no autopsy photographs that were released, blah, blah, blah. I'm not certain about that, but at least, you know, these guys are somewhat reputable to me.
Right.
I'll take their word for it. But my mom was like going, and she's like, "Oh no, they definitely took photographs." And I was like, "Okay, well then why didn't they release them?" And she's like, "Well, they were like so bad that like they didn't want anybody to see them because they were so bad." And it's like, okay, so just take our word for it. And then if you say it didn't happen, it'll cost you $1 billion, but we can't release the photos.
Yeah,
sure. And I was just thinking I don't really like getting into anything with her anymore because like.
It's like a losing battle.
And it's just like my mom.
Yeah,
like,
that's the thing. It's a losing battle because it's like, you know, her mind's made up on a lot of things.
Yeah.
And it's like, what are you going to convince her of that, of all things, too? Like, yeah, you got to pick and choose, I guess.
Yeah.
To what's really important at the end of the day. Like, what really has consequences.
Yeah, exactly. But it was just, like, frustrating to think of, like, literally, like, the Nashville shooting. Like, there was the video of the cops coming in, shooting them.
Yeah.
Or her. And I tried to misgender. And fucking, there was just like kids that were dead on the ground that they're running past, mm-hmm, in the video. Oh, okay. I guess we could see that one. I guess that was fine to see that. That didn't ruin people's psyche.
Yeah.
I don't know. Just, never, I really don't like the fucking line of thinking that this whole thing of like other people have decided what you can see, but then you're going to like go out on a limb and fucking defend like not knowing exactly. That's the thing I think with smart people, it happens a lot, and you would see it in college a lot too, where, yeah, it's that thing of you don't want to feel like you're you don't want to feel like you're like a step behind other smart people.
Yeah.
And you know, I just think it pops up a lot, and I think people should kind of like be a little more cognizant of how people are sort of interpreting like reality,
right,
kind of based,
right,
around that sort of notion. Like smart people, like that's the thing that's kind of frustrating, yeah, is like when smart people kind of like have these weird opinions that don't really match up with what you think someone should have. And a lot of it's that, at least to me, at least. I don't know.
Yeah, no, it's a current I've kind of noticed too, particularly in like academia, and just like, you know, you see it as early as high school and then college. And it's like a motivating, it's a driving force behind like better students who want to get like better grades and stuff. Like it's competitive to a degree, and they would freely admit that. I'd feel like it's not crazy theory right there. It's competitive, what they want to get done, and in that I feel like they there's an ego involvement, and that sometimes runs in the face of objective reality, for whatever that means, or just like having the humility to just have like a regular discourse or a regular like argument and not like a fight, or you know, the difference, or what do they call that, like not, or a debate rather than an argument.
Sorry. Oh yeah,
yeah, yeah,
yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, makes sense. It's just, yeah, it's just frustrating, that's all.
Oh yeah. Really, oh, dude.
It's kind of, yeah.
It makes you want to check out because it's like, it's so pervasive. It's all over. You know what I mean? It's not just like you run into one or two people. It's like most people.
Yeah.
Are just like, even despite their intelligence, are lemmings.
Yeah, That's the thing that's like frustrating with like our buddies, because they're all like pretty high IQ guys, like mm-hmm. really. And it's just like they just like will choose not to engage and stuff, because of that sort of, I guess. At least my read on it.
Yeah.
And it's just like, all right, you know, I guess. You know, it's kind of like you're asking them if they want to play catch or whatever, and they're like, no, we got better things to do.
Yeah, right.
They're just standing around. You're like, oh, okay, cool.
Right.
I don't know. Just frustrating.
Which I can see, it's like on one end, it's like we're tired of hearing about a specific topic, but it's like if they're going to bring it up and you're going to elaborate, it's like you don't want to go nowhere with it. You know what I'm saying? If they're engaging first.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
They throw the ball at you and walk away.
Yeah, that too.
I mean?
That too.
Yeah. Can't lose if you can't lose catch if you walk away.
You can't, dude. Can't do it. That's the thing with Embiid. He was like, listen, I can't lose the NBA Finals if I don't make it out of the second round. Yeah. That really does frustrate me. I think that would have been such a great finals matchup, the Sixers and the Nuggets. Because, you know, him and Jokic would have been great MVP guys, like battling back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. It just would have been nice. I wouldn't have minded losing to the Nuggets. Whatever. I don't know. Happy for Jokic. It was funny, like, after I was watching it here, I had to, like, plug the TV in. I was literally, like, holding the antenna up because, like, it wouldn't work.
Oh, my God.
So I'm just, like, standing like this for, like, 20 minutes watching the end of it. And so they interview him, like, 2 minutes after the last bucket, like, the last second comes out. And confetti's falling, and they, like, bring him over to ESPN, and they're like, yeah, so what do you think about, like, being the Heat? And he's like, oh, they were a good team. We had to beat them, and we just did need to do, okay, now I go home. He's just like, you know.
Stone-faced.
Eastern Bloc, like, Spurglord.
Jeez, what a.
Yeah, he rules.
Warrior mindset.
Yeah, it's great.
All that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah. Dude really is.
Nicest thing we can say about it.
Yeah. Dude really is a unit, dude. He's like fucking, he's got to be like 6'8", 6'9".
Yeah.
He's like, probably even taller. I'm probably shortchanging him. And just like a giant dude, man.
Yeah.
He has that weird hook shot where he doesn't do like the two-hand one. He kind of like hooks it in.
Mm-hmm.
It's wild.
You're saying, it's not just the tall. He has skill on top of it to ball.
Yeah, and he's, like, very quietly athletic. Like, he looks like he's, like, just, like, schlepping down the court.
Yeah.
It's fun to watch.
Right. Just unique.
Yeah. And, you know, he's white, you know, which that annoys a lot of black black NBA players for some reason that he won MVP. That was the best part. I mean, I loved Embiid getting MVP. I thought he deserved it.
Yeah, right.
Really, either one of them. It frequently comes to that every year. It's like there's 3-4 guys, then it comes down to 2 guys, either one.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like kind of a coin toss for the most part. I almost said toin cost, like a fucking retard.
Oh, a toin cost.
Dude, fucking.
I'm trying to get my toin cost later.
God, dude. I was on poll and somebody had some infographic of like symptoms of schizophrenia. And, like, it was, like your irritable mood, like, you know, you have no motivation.
Word salad.
Yeah, you have, like, word salad things. I'm like, oh, my God, what the
no.
fuck? Am I fucking schizo, like, without realizing it?
Probably spectrum-wise, but, like...
And then there's one where, like, you hear, like, audible hallucinations. And, like, dude, I shit you not, yesterday, like, you weren't home, like, right till, like, late at night.
Yeah.
I was, like, just in my room, and I hear, like, just, like, somebody saying, like, Dave. I'm like, oh, okay.
Are you
fucking
serious?
Yeah, dude.
Damn, bro.
And I'm like, it sounded like literally, like, maybe, like, you know, Justin was here. Like,
yeah.
I thought maybe you guys had come over.
Shit would
like,
scare the fuck out of me.
Yeah.
That's
and
scary.
So, I, you know, I was jerking off. So then I was like, all right, well, glad I just finished after somebody walked into the house. So I was like, all right. So I waited a minute.
Yeah.
Like, leave my room, and I'm walking around. And I'm like, oh, nobody's here. Oh, that's great. That's awesome.
Yeah,
that's cool.
Oh boy.
You know.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I never had I mean, knock on wood, any like audible hallucinations like that.
I don't know. Yeah, I mean, I
without chemical influence. But
yeah, that's the thing, people. You got to realize I literally don't do anything. I just like drink.
Yeah,
it's not
I
like
mean,
I'm,
neither do I. I don't this past, well, you know. let's not get on it.
But seriously, I just like, I smoke here and there, yeah. Like cigarettes and cigars, yeah. Like, and I drink. It's really not much.
Yeah.
Caffeine pills. I guess maybe that's it. Dude. Maybe it's the caffeine pills. No dose.
I don't know, man. I was looking at those. I was telling you, it's either, I think it's less than a cup of coffee or less than 2 cups of coffee.
Yeah.
It was for one dose.
Everybody always gives me shit about taking them. Like, I was talking with, like,
I think
C-bone.
It's the aesthetic is largely, like, just the way it is, like, the way it looks. Like, that's a big thing that plays into the cultural, interpretation of like substances.
Yeah, yeah.
Like meth, like if somebody's doing meth, you're like, what the fuck is wrong with this person? But really it's Vyvanse.
Yeah, yeah.
So
that was the thing, because I was talking with like C-Bone and my cousin. We're at the Eagles game, and like my cousin's like, oh yeah, like what do you do for work? And I was like, I don't know, I just like don't really eat breakfast. I just take like a caffeine pill halfway through the day. I'm good to go. And she was like, what the fuck? Like, and then, like, C-Bone's like, yeah, that's really not healthy.
Yeah.
I was like, what the fuck,
but
you guys?
The thing is, like, I guarantee at least one of those guys does the equivalent of that, if not more, caffeine through other means, by energy drink,
yeah.
By coffee, by tea. I have, three glasses of tea at work.
How about when C-Bone came over last week and you were like offering him to like all the, like you're, I don't know, you're being a great host, but you're like, do you want some salmon? I'm cooking up some salmon. He's like, yeah, no thanks. I want some egg salad. He's like, no thanks. How about some like hot tea? I know it's the summer, but fucking. Maybe some boiled cabbage.
He did bite on the egg salad though.
Yeah, there you go.
Despite the humidity and the heat, which is,
yeah, I don't know. I mean, I'm not a big egg guy myself. I just can't imagine gobbling those down.
No, it takes a hurdle if you're a picky eater, I think, because it's kind of a repulsive food. It has like a lot of sulfur. It smells like eggs.
Yeah, because I wanted to get into like Campbell's chicken noodle soup.
Yeah.
I wanted to like have that in my back pocket because it was pretty cheap and
it's easy.
Like I opened up the first can I got and it just reeked from those egg noodles. And I was like, nah, I'm good.
Might be no the thanks. Chicken too. I mean, yeah, I don't know. You can always make yourself just like throw some soup broth on or ramen. You ever get into the ramen noodles?
Yeah. I tried them because that was another thing. I wanted something cheap if you know, I had to save money. And those were, I don't know, like I could eat them, but it was just like, ugh, God, dude, it stunk. I'd rather eat mac and cheese, dude.
Yeah, mac and cheese is good.
Mac and cheese.
SpongeBob, get them shapes.
Dude, SpongeBob, Star Wars, Frozen, these are some great shapes, dude, as far as I can tell. The best is they got...
Yeah, I'm in shape in Frozen macaroni and cheese. No, Frozen the movie, Frozen 2.
They're not Frozen, it's the movie. It literally is Frozen 2, I think, too, like on the box. That's the best. Like, they'll run out of, like, the Scooby-Doo and they'll run out of the SpongeBob shapes. So you're left with, like, literally, like, trolls or, like, My Little Pony. It's like, well, what the fuck, dude?
Trolls.
Like, I guess I'll get it, but Christ, man. What the fuck? Yeah. That's my favorite thing is, like, this is the biggest psyop of all time. I think people got to speak
up. Just like
up
thinking,
on
like
it.
the poetic as I watched I stood on the shores and watched the erosion of time, and I watched as SpongeBob and Scooby Doo macaroni and cheese left the shelves. I was left with nothing but trolls. All right, you're saying.
No, I think you very like you know that was very well put, Mike.
Thanks.
Yeah, that was my exact state of mind. Fucking like literally. Fucking but no, so my big gripe, this is a huge psyop, I think. This is an all timer. No one really talks about it. They all kind of nod their head and shuffle along. Like sheep.
Sheeple.
Like sheeple. That fucking the big thing is when you're a kid, you say, I want the shaved macaroni and cheese. I like them more than the regular noodles. Parents say there's no difference. It doesn't matter. then you get older, and people keep sort of telling you this thing, and you get it sort of gets pushed out of your head to even want the shapes. It's yeah. seen as childish.
Mm-hmm.
You just always go for the regular noodles.
Right.
So if it doesn't matter that there are shapes versus the regular noodles,
yeah.
why would there ever be different types of pasta?
Yeah, I was just going to say, yeah.
Why would there be penne? Why would there be these little right. wheels? If it didn't matter, why would adults have different types of pasta?
And it matters, dude. I think there's more to food maybe they're leaving out than simply just like flavor and consistency. Like, there's other aspects. I don't know. It gets like orgiastic and gross, but there's like things called like mouthfeel. You know, it's like these like foodie terms people come out. You know, but it's a real thing. It's a real thing.
Mouthfeel.
Yeah, I've heard that one. It doesn't feel good to say. But
I don't want to think about
put it out there.
I don't want to think about the type of people that like unironically just use yeah. that term. Like, oh, that really like affected my mouthfeel in such a positive, intricate way. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Dude? What's going on with those fucking guys, dude? I don't like it.
Like Disney adults.
I'm thinking about it right now. Yeah, take it from a guy who has My Little Pony shaved macaroni and cheese. I don't like those guys. Yeah. Dude, fucking Disney adults, dude. They're taking some hardcore L's. The Star Wars fucking resort. Yeah, yeah. That was like, they were hinging so much money on like people spending like serious fucking cash to stay at like a 3-day weekend at these fucking like shit heap Star Wars like experience fucking things. It'd be like $5,000 like for a weekend.
Get the fuck out of here.
And it's like, yeah.
Get
like,
the fuck out of here.
What the fuck, dude?
Yeah.
So they're closing that shit down. Just, I don't know.
Good, fuck them.
I think they might have hit the bubble, dude, for Disney adulting. I don't know. Maybe it's just me.
Nah, because then there's like the classic stuff people grew up on. Like Star Wars is a newly acquired asset that they're trying to exploit and tank the series. There's like the classics, like in like the musical component, like the like. I feel like a lot of women and gay guys like gravitate to.
That's true, I guess. Yeah.
As far as like Disney adults go, I'm not like generalizing everybody.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I don't know, I guess. That was a big thing, like my folks, like, they really liked going to see Disney movies with me. It's like every once in a while one will pop up. Like, they wanted to go see Buzz Lightyear last year when mm-hmm. it came out.
Yeah.
Because that was, like, huge when I was a kid.
Yeah, they're well done.
Toy Story.
Yeah.
And they're like, oh, we got to see Buzz Lightyear.
Mm-hmm.
And I was just like no, like, I don't want to see, like, the new one's got like all this like gay shit in
it. Yeah, right.
And it's like I don't want to support yeah. that when it's being pushed towards kids. And,
yeah, real shit.
And like they don't even have Tim Allen as fucking Buzz Lightyear anymore.
Yeah.
So I was like,
a great voice actor too.
I know. It's not like he's dead. They just don't. Like
yeah. Wait, is it is it like a political thing with him? That they,
yeah, yeah, definitely.
I mean, really?
They replaced him with yeah. like Chris Evans or whatever. He's yeah. like a. star. It's like right. not like they're faced with nobody, but it's like
right.
bring him back, dude. Like, what the fuck?
Yeah, they just disagree with them, which is shallow and gay.
Yeah, and it's, you know, they totally do that. And then, like, you know, there's just shit like, you know, you look at these fucking executives that run Disney, and like the one dingbat that was like, oh yeah, like half of my children are like either pansexual or like non-binary. Yeah, I run one of the major companies that pushes media to kids.
Yeah, what that's a coincidence too.
Yeah.
Yeah. What are they? What's the joke? It's like the vegan dog. We all know who's making the decisions.
Oh, the vegan dog. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. It really is like that, dude. That was like I was telling you, like the chick I was dating for a bit. Like she was giving like. Anxiety drugs to her cat.
Yeah.
And I was like, Jesus Christ, down the line, this would be like my kid is like
yeah.
eight years old.
All medded up.
And it's like,
yeah, what was that
fuck, dude?
Statistic? It's from Dawson. I don't know. I haven't verified, but he was like saying like over a third of kids like kindergarten age and older or whatever that demographic are on some form of prescription medication.
So it even starts at kindergarten.
Yeah, I think that was the age he designated around that. It's fucking crazy, dude.
Yeah, I'd be interested to see a breakdown how that shapes out, like how many kids like in kindergarten, like percentage wise. Because
mm-hmm.
I'd imagine there's a lot of stuff because it's like, you know, you're hyperactive, hard to pay attention.
And yeah, a kid.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And I wonder how many parents just like, you know, pull the plug immediately. and start giving them, you know, shit that they can. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. The future ain't looking bright.
I was always a mild mannered kid, and I'd always kind of like do stuff on my own, like reading and like, you know, drawing and this and that. And I guess I never needed it, but I don't know, man. Yeah, then it's like those people just like grow up to be in our society, and like they just have to exist. And then like people are stunned when like everything just falls apart, you know. And there's like nobody cares about anything.
Yeah,
they've been drugged up their whole fucking life.
Right.
It's fucking, you know, it's crazy, man.
Well, yeah, that's the thing. Like, I mean, biggest thing, you see the bigger picture outlining itself, and it's, you're just literally destroying the identity of a country.
Yeah, or it's people. And then it's the people make up the country.
Yeah.
So it's like, yeah, great. So yeah. The nation of, like, drug addicts.
And it's just, like, really, after it comes down, you're just, it's just a husk. And it's like everybody's, you know, like, 300 and so million people are just, like, standing here. And they're just like, okay.
Yeah. Like, and they're not, they don't have any, like, motivation to do anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's crazy, dude.
Yeah, and then, like, you know, like, I don't know, that's, it's it seems significant, but we'll see how it plays out.
Yeah.
Let's get some popcorn
and kick back, dude. Yeah. Fucking, yeah. So, we didn't do a This Girl, That Girl yet, did we?
Oh, yeah.
So what are you thinking, Mike? I could pull some up.
Whitney Houston, Mariah Carey.
All right. Works for me. Whitney Houston. Whitney Houston was pretty hot, man.
Yeah, in her prime.
Like in like the 80s when she was like super big. That was the same photo. This is my favorite, this video. She looks so cute.
What video is that?
I Want to Dance with Somebody.
Oh, yeah.
They said Mariah Carey.
Yeah.
In her prime.
Yeah. What was she, like 90s Mariah Carey?
Yeah, yeah. So let's see. We'll do like 90s, yeah. This is a good one, Mike. Yeah, I gotta give it to you. Mouse is all fucked up.
Leave in the comments, you know, like and subscribe. Yeah, we probably should do a sponsor, dude. Sponsor of the cast is KYS Express Incorporated. They are a shipping agency out of Montana. KYS just wants to let our viewers know that they're offering shipping solutions for across the country at lowest rates. They're an insured Fortune 500 company. They're actually announcing a merger with Frontier GG Tradings Incorporated. So their merger is going to be KYS FGGT. It's going to be the new company name. We just want to let you know that. All right.
Oh, that'll probably really kick into high gear the shipping, you know.
Yeah, accelerate it. The backs will be falling out of the trucks. The bombs will be falling out.
Yeah, I like that you have a, like, you're like, yep, our sponsor, this real company.
Yeah, yeah. We get sued over it.
Yeah, it's like, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fuck them.
I don't think people need to overthink that one. But, okay. So, you know, I gotta be honest, Mariah Carey.
Hey,
in the
90s. Free clout, they call that.
Yeah,
American,
yeah.
Indiana's favorite podcast.
American Indiana's favorite podcast.
They just got featured.
They did, dude. They're going to have so much business now.
It's going to go through the roof.
Yeah, I think I got to definitely go with Mariah Carey in the 90s.
What's that bottom two pictures? Those are...
Of her?
Yeah. Wow.
Look at that.
Wow. Yeah, I gotta go. I was thinking Houston, very strong, but Mariah Carey's pretty smoking hot, dude.
It's like otherworldly.
Yeah, she's like Atlantean, maybe.
Yeah, and then, you know, she was still pretty hot, like, even to when, like, we were, like, kids, like, in the early 2000s.
Mm-hmm.
Then she porked up.
Yeah.
That was...
she had her phone.
My favorite thing of all time was the Vegas shooting happened. Pause. No. No, so it was, like, the Vegas shooting happened right as Mariah Carey was going to get interviewed by Piers Morgan on his, like, show. And they cut to him, and he's like, so we're just getting news right now. There's been a major mass shooting at, you know, Mandalay Bay, Las Vegas. And, you know, Mariah Carey, you're here for an interview. We needed to get that out there. And they cut to her, and she's showing, like, her Christmas gimmick, because it was in October.
Yeah.
And she's, like, laying down on, like, a chaise lounge in, like, weird Christmas dress, with, like, a giant Christmas tree behind her.
Oh my god.
And he's like, I just, you've played Las Vegas in your career. I just was wondering if you had any sort of thoughts or comments. And she was like, because she's got like that weird fat girl voice where now they talk like guys. And she's like, yeah, it's not good. It's bad. It's tragic. It's so bad. It's like just the most insane thing.
Yeah.
Just the fact that. Why would he ask her if she had any thoughts on it? Like, what the fuck? God damn.
Yeah, dude. It was like when 9/11 happened and they asked Tom Green when he was in a vat of horse glue.
Yeah, what was the famous one? Like
Ja Rule.
Ja Rule.
Yeah, that's
Chappelle's
thing. Yeah, Chappelle's joke. It's just fantastic.
You know. My favorite, this is like on an anniversary thing they were doing, 9/11. And it was some lady was like at some morning talk show. And they were like, she was like, you know, the thing of that day, that 9/11, it was just such a beautiful day. It was really just the most wonderful 9/11 I ever remember.
What the fuck?
And they were like, what are you talking about, lady? Like, she meant like weather-wise. Like, it was before it happened, it was like the most picturesque day.
And then it just sounds like a Trump. It was a beautiful 9/11. Like, he's on the side of the terrorists.
He said
Saudi
that.
Arabians.
He did. He talked about the world wars. He's like, we had two world wars, two beautiful world wars. Yeah. Like, what?
What was the Sam Hyde when he did the Drexel TED Talk? And he was like, aside from blah, 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 it just shows you what can be accomplished when 11 guys put their minds together and set out for a goal. Talking about, like, 9/11 and the, like, hijackers.
Oh, man. It really is, like, the greatest thing ever that he did that fucking... Drexel TED Talk. TED Talks are so funny. That was like a huge like fart sniffing contest that like midwits got into. Like, when we were in high school, people like teachers really play fucking videos for us. Like see kids, now you're learning something. It's like, all right, yeah, I guess. And then you find out it's like just like all funded by fucking like Bill Gates and like the Rockefeller Foundation shit.
Right.
Just pushing like retard shit.
And like who doesn't have a TED Talk at this point? It's like...
Dude, I've given a TED Talk.
Yeah.
Like literally in Philly.
My dog's given a TED Talk.
Like that was what was so nuts. Like when I did one, it was like obviously it was small scale. Like,
wait, did a TED Talk?
Yeah.
Holy shit, I thought you were joking.
No, I did like, I'm telling you, it was a smaller thing.
Yeah.
But it's like, did one and it's like, this is like stupid.
Right.
I'm fucking getting invited.
Yeah,
no. But,
Groucho Marx.
Yeah. You know. And when I was done, that was Ed's favorite thing because somebody took a video of it at the end and I did like the Nixon.
Yeah.
Like the double.
Oh,
like,
that's fantastic.
Victory piece. Yeah. Here.
Good shit.
Yep. Fucking, man, dude. Whitney Houston, for such a hot lady to get so unbelievably mogged in this way, that's just brutal, dude. Dude, Mariah
that's
Carey,
what she is, man.
God, you know, Mariah Carey, it might be Pantheon tier early.
I didn't realize.
I always knew she was hot, but it's like, my God, dude.
Well, this is what This Girl or That Girl's about. You know, you get a renewed appreciation for beautiful women.
Well, what a beautiful woman.
What a beautiful woman.
Dude, imagine fucking... We've said it before, but it's like Mariah Carey versus Ice Spice. I mean, what the fuck, dude?
Yeah.
It's not even
close. They're not sending there. Even... Who was it? The last one. Like, 4 years ago model.
The singer chick?
Mm-hmm.
Cardi B?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
well, Cardi B's nothing to write like, him about.
She looks like a chick that works at fucking, like, Taco Bell.
Yeah.
You know what
I
mean?
And I get, like it's more of a hip-hop, like rapping, I guess, for her, right?
Yeah.
So you're not relying on the traditional, like, singer, like, being beautiful and, like, being a singer, I guess.
Yeah, yeah.
But still, like, there's not a big enough pool of, like, it doesn't take a lot of skill to, like, rap, I feel like.
I think it takes almost no skill.
Yeah, so it's like you can't find a hot woman to do that.
I'm going out on a limb.
You know what I mean?
I'm saying it's the easiest thing in the world.
Yeah.
I don't know. I mean, it probably takes some skill.
I feel like there's levels to it.
I think you just, like, if you really want to do it, you could just do it and, like, get decently good at it.
Right.
Like, just for, like...
As far as music goes.
Putting the hours in.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I don't think it's, like... It's not exactly painting the Sistine Chapel.
You're not Miles Davis.
No, you're not. You're not.
You're not.
You're not Miles Davis. Damn, dude. Mariah Carey is fucking a sweet angel. My God, dude. Can't believe it. Look at that. Look at that. This is great stuff, dude. People at home, you can't see the photos we're looking at. These are some great photos.
Do your own research.
Yeah, really, actually, yeah, you should do your own research. Because this is great research I'm pulling up right now, dude. Psst. God. Yeah. Yep. Well, I don't know. I guess Trump got indicted.
Oh, yeah, that happened.
That was like a big deal. I just can't take it seriously.
What I'm supposed to react about or yeah, something like
because it just seems like they always think they're gonna get him every time, and it's like they just do worse and worse shit. So I'm like annoyed by that. Like the,
yeah, right.
Like the fucking.
It's clearly getting more underhanded.
Yeah, and pretending like it doesn't matter.
Right.
Or like it's like on the up and up, and they're doing this because he's a bad guy.
Right.
And
right.
Because it's like you know they're going after the one guy that's you know. Which is also my thing of him, like, you know, everybody does this whole thing, like, oh, he's just as bad as blah, blah, blah. It's like, mm-hmm. If he was, they would not be doing all this.
Right, right, right.
And, so, that's kind of my read on it. You know, people could disagree, I have no problem, right. But it's hard for me to really buy into the whole thing of he's on board, because I don't think, they've never done this to anybody else. They don't do it to Clinton, never did it to Bush. Bush, you would have thought they were going to like put him in front of Nuremberg 2.0.
Nah, he's a team player.
And it's like, nah, they love him now. He's funny. He does paintings.
They bring him up.
Yeah. He's giving candy to Michelle Obama.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking, but yeah, dude, fucking, like, I don't know. I can't take it seriously. I just feel like he's just one of those guys that, like, he just always walks through a minefield.
Yeah, like, right.
Unscathed.
Right.
Somehow.
Yeah, and
Mr.
Hope,
Magoo, dude.
You hope so, because, I mean, that you were getting at it, like, earlier into that is just the great fence-sitter take where it's like they both suck. And it's like, okay, then... And then it's like after that, it's like, but I'm just going to vote for the Dems because it's less intrusive. Like, it's less annoying to hear about. And it's like, okay, but, like... The quality of living for everybody's going to drop, and it's objective, and it's proven to happen, and it has happening. It's happening right now. So it's like, my thing is, it's like, yeah, they both suck, but one's a lot worse.
Yeah.
So like, if you're going to vote, like, I mean, to me, it'd be like the Republicans right now. But I don't like the Republicans.
And it could easily shift, like it has in my lifetime.
I mean, like, I picked the fucking RFK because he said. He's going to try to dissolve, it's not going to happen, but dissolve, like, the letter agencies.
Yeah. You know, somebody brought up an interesting thing with RFK. My voice keeps cracking. They brought up, I'm sorry, like, okay,
fuck. Get into character.
Yeah, yeah. They were saying the thing with him that's kind of like a nauseating thought is not that he would unseat Biden for the Democrat nomination, but Biden would still be a Democrat. It would be Trump for the Republicans. And then RFK is like the independent, and he's got serious support, and he swings support from Trump voters who would have liked Trump because he's also sort of anti-establishment the way RFK is.
Right.
But RFK is fully anti-vax, whereas Trump's sitting back saying, I don't understand. My vaccine was great. I don't know why anybody cares.
Yeah.
And it would be enough to, you know, give it right back to Biden. That's...
Well, what do you mean? Like, because, like, he'd lose in the primaries, and then it would be Biden-Trump, so wouldn't they just swing back those independent voters?
No, like, he would be running as the third independent.
Oh.
And it would be, like, sort of like a ploy of, like, yeah, the Democrats being like, oh, well, we forced him out, and then he feels he's got a shot, runs. Which, I mean, that was like you were saying. It's, I would live totally comfortably if it was RFK. T-Dog.
Yeah, either or.
I'd be fine with it. But
even just, I hate fucking Bernie Sanders. Like, it's annoying. Like,
oh yeah, he's a terrible person.
The fucking shit. Like, yeah. it's such a fucking like the people just like put the T-shirt on, but they really just like don't understand basic policy. I mean, I just don't like people who are pro-war. So he's kind of lost me on that. Trump's less pro-war than anybody we've had over the last 20. You could say longer years.
Yeah.
That alone, I kind of like, but like, you know, that's not like on people's mind, you know, because it's out of sight.
Yeah. Plus, I mean, my main thing with Trump is I just think he has like a lot of better ideas for like America, like gaining like financial independence and stability, and like looking out for our country first over others. And you know, I just think Bernie has terrible fucking ideas for the economy, and I think he's really like an idiot.
Yeah, real shit. He's just like, and the thing is, on top of that, like, he's like put on there as like the outsider, but he's the team player too. He's along with all those decisions.
Yeah.
But like that being said, I would take him any day of the year over Joe Biden.
Yeah, I don't know. That's a tough one.
Nah, he'd easily.
Yeah, because the thing with Biden is he's like, he's really good at.
He is funnier though.
He is funny. That's the thing, Mike. You got to remember, pretty funny that he invited a hot tranny that took her tits out at the White House.
Remember the rules.
I know. I don't know.
Rules of engagement.
Yeah. But like the thing I really don't like about Biden is he plays into the Democrat center left sort of thing of they want someone that they can like feel comfortable supporting.
Right.
And he masks a lot of the terrible things that people are voting for when they vote for him. Like he masks like them pushing
by straight up lying.
Yeah. Like he masks like how bad the economy is.
Right.
You know, the Ukraine war is going great.
Yeah.
How
just lies.
Know, they're not cutting kids' tits and dicks off and, you know, this shit. And, you know, he stands at Independence Hall and says half the country is, you know, a danger to the other half. Just
more so than that, a terrorist, like terrorists. Yeah.
So he masks a lot of that, whereas I don't think Bernie would be able to. And therefore, I think Bernie would probably be better for people not to feel like they're on the good guy side all the time and they can't see past it. Maybe. Yeah. I just worry with Bernie about I really worry how he would ruin the economy with just like government spending and like just crippling things and just seeming to not have like an understanding of how to like keep things like stable.
Right. And I mean, what's this guy doing though too? It's interesting you said that characteristic about Biden, too. It's almost like an avatar, like a manifestation of something we kind of, like, talked about prior, previously. And it's just like this almost like feminine energy, not to, like, bash on women, just in that kind of pillar. Or of nebulous kind of just that, like nebulous nothingness where precipitates out like or hides these like evil decisions, and he's like an avatar of that by nature of his like severe Alzheimer's.
Oh yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like it's just like this.
Oh yeah, totally.
You know what I mean? It's yeah, it's funny how it's
not like,
it like that.
He's sitting there like, you know, plotting.
Yeah, mastermind. Like, he ain't Dark Biden.
Yeah, and yeah. Now I'm gonna.
The only dark spots are in his fucking brain memory, like Swiss cheese.
Dude, yeah. It's not like he's sitting there like. Yeah, now, like, oh, your kids are going to be, like, you know, infertile by the time they're 13. Yeah, and, like, it's only going to be for white kids. So the population will shift drastically. Yeah, this is my master plan. It's like, he's just an idiot that's getting spun around mm-hmm. like the headless chicken to whatever cause. And you're right. Like, he hides this nebulous cloud of, like, really it's, like, consequences for a lot of these things. And yeah. That's the thing that, you know, you hear it like we were talking today about the walkable city bullshit and... It's like, yeah, it's literally college-educated white women love the idea, the nebulous idea of a 15-minute walkable city. None of them think about who are they in the city with. What, like, you know, can they leave the fucking city? Because mm-hmm. that seems like that's a pretty quick, now you're shut down in your 15 minutes.
Yeah.
Can't drive, you just got to walk. And it's like, I think that's the problem with a lot of, like, shit-lib stuff is just like, yeah, it sounds nice, but you're not thinking about it compared to everything else. Like, the whole idea of, like, oh, we have a homeless crisis in America. There's a houseless problem, blah, blah, blah. It's like, okay, well, how about we stop importing all these immigrants? How about we, like, clamp down on immigration?
Yeah.
And then they're not using up space that we could maybe put these people in. If you even take it at the face value of these people just need a place to stay. And you're like, well, no, we can't do that. It's like, okay, well, that's just like a simple fucking thing that you could fix.
Right.
But no. And then Subjective. It's like, same thing of like, you could do it for like fucking, like wages. It's like, you know, they suppress wages because they come in and they're paid under the table, much cheaper, and they're suppressing the hourly wages for American workers that they can earn. Oh, no, can't stop it, can't do anything. All right, sounds good, man. That's the thing. I just...
Yeah.
It's, you know, it's... Like I said, it's just frustrating that, you know, all these people, you know, they act like they're fucking, you know, geniuses over this shit. That's, I don't know. It's not like I am.
But can't answer the first question. Yeah, I'm not, I mean, I'm not the, like, you know where I'm at.
There certainly could be shit I'm missing.
Yeah.
I'm not thinking about.
But that's how you, that's how you learn and that's how you get further. You're not. Your ego is not tied to whatever premise you're putting forward. You're just trying to find the objective truth so people can live better.
Yeah.
It's not about, like, but, you know, it's people, they're very underdeveloped in that sense a lot of times.
Yeah. And then I feel like it also, like, always goes back to, like, well, everything's bad anyways. And
yeah, well, that's back to, like, the nebulous, you know, duck soup of it.
Like the corporations and the CIA...
Yeah. Yeah. Right.
Okay.
That,
cool.
And that it seems to work in this, you know, this the favor of it. Like,
yeah.
That's why
yeah,
I
definitely.
Like Ryan Dawson often. He'll name names. Like he puts the names together. He names the people. Like he broke like the Epstein. He was dropping names and stuff. Like, it's not like this vague, you know, like. The Jews or the deep state or the globalist. It's not this faceless umbrella. It's he can name the people, which is great, and that's what needs to happen, you know. But
yeah
you need to have journalists, but that's a different, you know, conversation.
Yeah it's just you know, I just, that's my thing with a lot of, and kind of why I like doing the podcast, just being able to talk this stuff out, because it can just get so like anxiety inducing the way people
right
just kinda,
it's a Twilight Zone episode, it's a mind trip.
They like channel out and they just they, you know, just tune out everything, and it's like they've accepted everything's going to be shitty. They don't care. And
right,
it's, you know, it's,
well, that's a guarantee shame. Things will be shitty.
Yeah, exactly. So self-fulfilling prophecy much? Hello. Yeah. See ya, dude. We did This Girl, That Girl.
Yeah.
Fucking
TG dash TG.
Yeah. Fucking American Eaters for a podcast. Mariah Carey. We both chose Mariah Carey.
Yeah.
Slam dunk.
It's a zero to toe.
Sorry, Whitney. Houston. So yeah, dude, fucking God is great. Crisis.
Some people stand in the darkness. A friend to step into the light. Some people need to help somebody when the edge of surrender's in sight. It's gonna be alright. I'm always ready. I won't let you out of my sight. Never you feel it. I'll be ready. I'm on the I'm here.